at the APA of Missouri and Maryland Heights, the Puppy Cam. Remember, the NAMI Walk to Raise Awareness of Mental Illness is this weekend at the Chesterfield Amphitheater. Dogs are welcome. It's going to be warm, though. Just make sure to bring water, treats, and a non-retractable leash. The walk steps off at 9 a.m. So have you ever looked at an adorable dog and wondered, what is that dog and can it be part of my family? How fast can I make that happen? We have Laura Mulder. She is owner of Who's My Mutter and she has a new app. So we have a St. Louis based app. I think that is just so cool. Tell us about it. Tell us how it works.
Sure. So the app is actually facial recognition for dogs. It's the first ever facial recognition for dogs. It uses a series of photos to determine the dominant breed in a dog. It is very particular. It is like any other facial recognition. It needs certain points in the face to actually give you justice on the breed. But if you do it correctly and you follow the instructions, it will give you a very solid result.
When you're talking about possibly adopting a dog, does this help someone figure out, is this dog good for my family?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And on top of that, speaking of adopting dogs, the app also pushes rescues and shelters all over the world. Okay. So the beauty of that is you can go to the app, you move to China, you can go to the app, you can download the app, you can click on shelters, it'll pull up any shelter within a 50-mile radius and show you all the dogs that they have available in that shelter and how to contact the rescue. So it heavily promotes rescues and shelters all over the world as well.
That is so cool. Yeah. Okay, so we'll get into the rescue part later, but when did you decide that facial recognition was something that a lot of families needed?
So I rescued a litter of dogs and I rescued their mom at the same time. I ended up adopting one of the puppies who I knew had some medical issues as he progressed in size. And I knew what his mom was. I knew his mom was a small 35-pound pit bull, but you know, at 4 months, he was 35 pounds.
You're like, what is going on here?
So I wanted to do a DNA test on him, which I did. And I feel like I maybe probably got some decent results on it. However, it's expensive. And there are so many people out there in the world that love their animals just as much as I do, but can't afford a DNA test in order to get, you know, a diagnosis from a doctor or whatever it may be in order to help their pets. So really, it was kind of a low cost, affordable way to get the same results that you would from a DNA test. Okay. However, it can only show you the dominant breed. And we'd like to dig a little bit deeper down the line.
And we only have a couple seconds. Could you introduce us to your friend here?
This is Gia.
Hi, Gia.
A rescue.
Hey, have some more treats.
She was actually rescued through Four Paws for Rescue.
Oh, awesome.
And
she is super chill.
She's an amazing dog. She's very puppy. We're thinking about training her for touch therapy, but right now she's a little too puppy for that at this point. She's gone through a couple of the classes, but she needs to kind of get the puppy out of her first.
All right. Well, I can tell you she is like super chill, but we'll go ahead and see what happens. Until then, everybody, the app is available on both iPhone and Android. Go ahead and see what you're getting into at whosmymutter.com. Now let's send it back over to Lisa for some more news.